Death Valley. Gold mining town. It was almost a dead town there, but gold, price of gold has kind of reactivated the town. All these little mines are going again. Little houses are starting to get fixed up. People got motorhomes. All kind of stuff here. I'm going to pull over and let all this traffic by me so I can go through here a little slower and get up here. Places have gotten cleaned up. And
pardon all the bug stains.
They might even reopen the Silver Dollar Saloon up here someday. There, now we can go through at a decent speed.
It's clear back there.
A few artists in the area too. Yeah, it's all cleaned up. You should have seen it before. It looked terrible around here. The Silver Dollar Bar Cafe. I'll bet that opens up again. It's closed right now. I've been in there when it was open. Silver Dollar Saloon, yeah. All these old little mining shacks and stuff. A couple of vintage trailers and stuff over there. Look who shows up last.
Corey and I got here about 11:30. We were starting to wonder, going, did they already take off? What's up?
Fashionably late.
Yeah, fashionably. Funny. Ballarat. Say hello, Rocky. We'll get you on video here. Rocky Novak, likes to be called Rock.
Where you guys going today?
We're going out to Striped Butte Valley.
You're going to be in for an adventure.
Yeah, we're going to stay out there for a few days.
You going to camp out there?
Oh yeah, we're going to camp out there.
Yeah, that'd be a quite a trip. You know that canyon that the mountain water washes been fixed a couple days ago?
Oh really?
Yeah, they say you can get up there in a two-wheel drive.
Oh, well, we all got four-wheel drives.
Too bad. Steps. Road and being rough, the county fixed all that.
Oh, too bad. Here we thought it was going to be fun.
Like a rough.
Yeah.
A challenge.
Yeah. Darn it. Oh well. Well, we'll be by to see you again on Sunday or Monday when we come back out.
I have the drinks cold.
Okay.
Hopefully, my solar's still working.
Yeah. Keep the drinks cold. We'll be here.
Yeah, we'll keep them
cold. All righty. Let's take a look at the store here.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Old general store. How old is this store?
And it was built in 1968 or 69. The guy that originally built that, he's going to put in a store, kind of a gas station. These doors here, the French doors, used to be garage doors.
Ah.
I took the garage doors out, and the owner, he put the French doors in there. There's one on this side and one on this side. And he's going to put in a gas station, a bunch of stuff, and I guess he wants to make kind of a little restaurant or something.
Another Panama Springs resort type thing, huh?
Yeah. That's what he was planning on doing, and I guess he's going to make a kind of a trailer court out here. And then he dug some wells out here, and the water just turned out to be salt brine.
Yeah.
You know, it wasn't fit for human consumption, so kind of ended that. And it's kind of hard to run a trailer court on a half-inch water line.
Yep.
So that kind of put the end of that. It just led from one thing to another.
And here you are.
Yeah, more buildings keep falling down. That schoolhouse over there fell down a couple of years ago. Had a real bad storm come through here. Rain, real hard wind, probably an 80-mile-an-hour wind that took it down.
Ooh.
Good wind down.
In a way, I hate to see it, but in a way, you know, it's better if the damn thing did fall down because it was just hanging up by a spider web. Now I was scared to death some kids are going to get in there and get to climb around on stuff. You know how they do it.
Safer, yeah.
And they touched the wrong thing. That whole building could have caved.
It's my jailhouse. Oh, yeah. Last time,
yeah,
I, was
jailhouse
here,
is
last
still
time I was here, I slept in, my father slept in the jail.
Oh, neat.
Or the morgue, whichever you want to call it.
Yeah, well, it was both, wasn't it? Morgue and the jailhouse.
So I'm kind of glad it did fall down, you know?
Yeah.
Because somebody would get hurt in there. Yeah. And they've been moving people, you know, they like to make movies in there and stuff like that. And it's the slightest little thing that whole thing gets caved in on.
Wow.
And
still $2 a night. Well, you can't beat it for camping.
Yeah.
$2 a night.
That would be it.
All righty.
You know, $3 a night, you know. And the good thing about it is private land. You're not being harassed by the park or the BLM. You know, they don't come around.
Yeah. And not too many rules either, really.
No, there ain't no rules. They can bring the fireworks, they can target shoot, they can build bonfires, have barbecues, run around naked. I don't care shit what they do.
Especially the women.
Yeah, have the generators running. But
all right. Well, I guess we're going to get ready to go.
Mm-hmm. Place to come to have fun, man.
Yep.
Yep.
No prohibited signs.
Yeah, I love it.
I'm sure.
All right, we just left Ballarat. We're on Briggs Road now. Well, actually, it's not Briggs Road. But I forget what they call this road. But anyway, we're headed towards Goler Wash. We're going to take Goler Wash through these mountains. You see off to the left here. To Striped Butte Valley. Another pretty famous place. It's in the southeastern part of Death Valley. It's only 85. Not bad at all. It's 95 at home. It's only 85 here. It's a little after noon. It's a little after 1. There's everybody out there. Clean the windshield. Already got new bugs on it. Yeah, here we go. Looking back into Panamint Valley north. We're just about ready to enter Goler Canyon right there, Goler Wash. And we're gonna follow this to Mengel Pass, over that into Striped Butte Valley. Yeah, having fun? All right, mouth of Goler Wash, Goler Canyon. Getting ready to go here. Got me and Chris. We got Corey, Snow Nymph. We got Slacker, who is Rob, standing up there. And leading us is Eric and Chris, in Chris's Jeep, the red Jeep. Say hi, Rob.
What's up, Larry?
We're gonna have fun.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's already happy hour. Hi, Corey. The window's kind of dusty, but this canyon is just awesome. Let's see if I can get it around here. People die out here unless they blow their brains out. A few people have decided to do that lately. But yeah, so far we've seen a lot of water in this canyon. LA is running out of water, but Death Valley's not. Look at all the flowers. Springtime in Death Valley. Just past the Keystone Mine. I forgot about that one. We might stop in there on the way back. If we have time. Might even hit the Newman Cabin on the way back if we have time. We're gonna be out here for 4 days. Death Valley National Park. Barker Ranch, 1 mile. That's a new sign. Butte Valley, 5 miles. We're going to Butte Valley, but we're going to stop at Barker's Ranch. And we're going to cross the creek. And the water in this one, but it flows underneath us here. Must be a culvert under the road. Because it is wet. Alright, back to driving. 1 mile to Barker Ranch. Almost there. It's nice in here. Big growth in here. I love the windshields, the dirty windshield. I mean, I cleaned it in Trona, but now it's all dusty. I hope it's not hurting the video much. Been here a long time. All right, there was a million Jeeps. There was actually probably 12 of them. taken up all the parking at Barker's Ranch. So we didn't even bother pulling in. And, you know, we could have stopped and walked around, but we want to beat them to Butte Valley. I know that's where they're going. And if they beat us there, we won't get a cabin. We still might not get a cabin, but we didn't want to give them a chance in front of us either. So we'll just stop at Barker's on the way back. But yeah, we want to beat them to Butte Valley because we have a better chance of getting a cabin that way. There's like three or four cabins out there that are pretty nifty. So here we go. We have 5 miles to Butte Valley. Barker's Ranch, they're behind us now. We gotta beat them to the cabin, so I'm holding it back. That way Chris can race to the cabin. They're way up front. Well, my clutch is a little bit broken. Lost a bushing, but we're going to be able to fix it, so I'll be able to get home. But yeah, we had some rough stuff to go over. I couldn't even film it. So here we are. I forgot the name of this cabin. Is this Russell's? Stella's. This is Stella's cabin. Okay. We just put up our flag. Haven't used this in a while. Slacker knows where this is, doesn't he?
The Nelson, that's it. We call it the Lee Hilton.
Lee Hilton?
It's fucking nice as hell. I was in there. I was amazed.
You guys look too comfortable.
That was.
In the snow, we're staying there.
There's where we'll cook. There's our fireplace.
My friend and I found that.
There's our flag. There's our view. This is Striped Butte Valley. You can't see the butte from here. Tomorrow I'll get a picture of it. It's over to the left. It's over that hill.
Every year he goes.
You get stuck on a flat spot?
He gets stuck where you could park a Camry next to it. His Jeep. He's back a half hour behind me. I'm like, what the hell is this guy doing?
Some friends.
So I back up. I gotta see. I look. He doesn't want to get on the CB because he doesn't want me to see. So he's running up the wash with his winch cable trying to find something to hook it to when I came back. He's all, oh, I'm all, what are you doing? There's not even any rocks on the road. And it was one rock he got underneath him. In the middle of the road.
All it takes.
Some friends, we were down at. It sure was nice to have phone service and all that,
Beatty,
you know?
Was nice. Yeah, because then everybody
Beatty.
Can talk and share with their stuff, you know, their tablets in the evening. I mean, it's technology taking it over, so.
You can, yeah. I mean, the thing about it is, like, I haven't even been coming around nearly as long as you guys, and it's like, I'm not sick of Panamint Valley or anything like that.
We are.
Yeah, so that's what I mean. I can imagine.
We've done it to death.
How many times can you do those same runs and all those things?
Actually, I can still do Pleasant Canyon.
Well, that's still
fun.
Pleasant's always fun.
Yeah.
That haven't done it.
I understand.
So that makes it cool.
Yeah, and it makes it cool to show it to new people, and there's a lot to see.
But now the new people have already seen it.
Yeah, so.
A lot of them. 90% of them.
I would still do a party at Briggs Camp. That's a really neat place. And bring all the guns.
Yeah.
And the fireworks and, you know, and all that stuff.
Good.
Yeah, and then go drive across the illegal bridge a bunch of times, both directions.
Yeah. I do a lot of my own loading up. If anybody wants special protection loads, I do 38 Special, 357 Mag, 44 Mag, 10 millimeter auto, and 45 ACP.
Talk to him.
Anybody who wants.
Did you bring your black powder gun?
No.
Oh, you got a black? I always like that. You pull the trigger, the big puff, you wait for it, boom!
He's got a handgun, and you can tell by using that thing that the shootouts were not what they seem in the movies, because you pull the trigger once, and then you have to, like, move to see your target.
Yeah,
because I can't see. Wait till the smoke clears. I want to get a good, clean shot at you.
Yeah.
It
doesn't put out as much smoke.
Fuck.
I like the smoke, though.
It is cool.
I like the smell.
Open range. Yeah. That was the best. That was actually the most realistic looking shootout at the end there. They're all really close.
Yeah.
Smoke everywhere.
Smoke everywhere, yeah.
Yeah. It seemed more realistic than any shootout I've seen on in the movies.
I have a 69 it's a 69 caliber flintlock pistol. From me to you, I probably couldn't hit you with it.
Really?
You could fucking
throw
think
it
that
at him.
Inaccurate. I mean,
yes, that rifle. I never rifled it.
I was trying to hit a bowling pin at 10 feet, my brother and I. And
you hit the guy
we shot until we kept trading until we ran out of balls, and the pin was still standing right there. And each time we'd shoot, it's like, did you see where it goes? Because you know it's not moving fast, and it's like, fuck, I didn't even see where the fuck it went.